So after doing the 2019 Mac Pro unboxing video, I've gotten an influx of brand new viewers to my older videos and a lot of new comments on those videos. And one of them was for my 14 terabyte Xserve RAID video. And it made me think, this thing has PCIe slots in it. I've got a card from LSI Logic, which was designed in 2005, but has PCIe on it. I also have the Xserve RAID, which was designed in 2002, and a 2010 MacBook sitting here to turn this thing on remotely. Let's try it and see what would happen. I haven't updated this system yet. It's still running Monterey, but I believe Monterey supports the LSI card. And this should be pretty straightforward and a pretty short video, but we're not sure yet. So let's see what happens. It never turned on. That turns on. You gotta be kidding. Okay, so before we start actually doing this, I want to explain how we're doing it. First, we need to put this fiber card into here so we can connect these fiber cables to the Xserve RAID. Then we've got this MacBook right here so we can remotely start this thing so I don't have to reach behind it. And we've got the Xserve RAID plugged into this Airport Extreme right here so the MacBook can connect to this wirelessly to start it up. Pretty simple. There's nothing else connected to this other than the Xserve RAID. So, yeah. And the reason why we need this is because the Xserve RAID management software is 32-bit only. And this right here is running Mojave, and the software works fine on Mojave. So we'll be able to remotely start this by just using this. So anyway, let's get the Mac Pro open and start going. I love how it gets stuck on these tracks. Beating the heck up. Okay. So, I need to take these out. So now, we have the old ancient card in here. And we are ready to put the cover back on and hook it up. So let's get to it. The card's not even connected very well. This may or may not work. It also won't plug in. Come on. There we go. There's one. It no reach. You're kidding me. It won't reach. Yeah. All right. It's hooked up. Now we just need to plug it in and hook up a monitor, and we'll be good to go.
Neat.
The adapter doesn't work. Yay. Mac light's going out on this. It's lovely. All right. So as stupid as this may look right now, we've got everything hooked up. Let's open up the MacBook. Let it reconnect to the Wi-Fi. Make sure it's on the right Wi-Fi. It is. It's reading communications errors. Really? Right now? Come on! Oh. Okay. Now it's connected. If we're lucky, when this kicks on, it'll show up on the desktop. If we're not lucky, I don't know what to do, and this might have been a pointless video. Yeah, let's see. And power on. It's a good sign. Here comes the hard drives. It should start populating about now. Now, will you start populating? There we go, they're online. Ready? Okay, they're on. Don't see anything. I definitely don't see anything. This isn't a good sign. It's worth a shot. All right, so hi from hours later. It's been multiple hours since I was running Monterey. I got Catalina on here, which is not easy when you've never downgraded a T2 Mac before. I've upgraded my friend's T2s, but I've never downgraded. And you've got to go into recovery. You've got to disable all the security features for everything, basically. And then you've got to wipe the drive because the drive is locked until it's wiped. It took me forever, but we're running Catalina now. I'm pretty sure this card worked in Mojave, and Catalina is the oldest OS this thing will run. So, let's see what happens. Drives are online. Nothing's showing up yet. Card doesn't show up. So needless to say, this doesn't work with this. But now I'm at this point where I'm determined to get it to work on something. So I guess let's try this. I think this is running High Sierra. It should work on it, but we'll have to use some other means to get it connected. So I guess let's get to it. Well, it can't apparently Thunderbolt and close a fiber card. In High Sierra, at least. It might work if I hacked it to run the graphics drivers, but it just sees the Thunderbolt enclosure. It doesn't see the card in it. Although in High Sierra, it does indeed have fiber channel support, so at this point, I'm just determined to get this to connect to a modern system, even if it's not really modern and was actually built for it anyway, but besides the point. Let's hook up the 5,1 and at least finally get these drives to actually work in something more modern. Very disappointing video so far and quite frustrating. Let's go. So we had to go down three generations to make this work. This should work. And if you could run an older OS that was 32-bit compatible with apps and stuff, this Mac Pro right in front of me, the 7,1, probably would work too. I figure these are 32-bit drivers, which would make sense because they probably haven't been really rewritten since early Intel days. But now, this should work, because if it didn't work, that would be really sad considering this was one of those systems that was built for this. I see drive activity. Hey! Cool, it works! Duh! Of course it would. Yeah. There's that drive. And there's that drive. It works! Yay! I don't know what I was expecting. I mean, of course this would work. Wish it would have worked on something else that was newer. Yeah, anyway, let's wrap up the video. So yeah, guys, I've got my legs under this table right now. Kind of nervous because the table's making really scary noises. There's a lot of weight on this table. And I may lose my legs if this thing collapses, so hopefully it doesn't. But yeah, that's the disappointing ending to this video, where I wanted to try to get this Xserve RAID to run on a newer Mac Pro, not the one it was actually sort of kind of designed for. I mean, even by then, the Xserve RAID was dead, but you could still get fiber cards for it, and it was still compatible with it. So, yeah, it's disappointing, but hey, we tried it, it didn't work. Now, if there's a fiber card out there that you guys know of that is 64-bit compatible, please let me know, because I'd like to try to get this Xserve RAID to connect. And I'd say there's a fiber adapter out there for Thunderbolt, maybe also, which would be handy, because then we could get this to work with it, too. Even if I had a Thunderbolt 2 enclosure, it might work. But the Thunderbolt 3 enclosure just doesn't want to work with it. So, yeah, can't get this Xserve RAID to work with these two. Works fine with that one as long as it's running a compatible OS. Yay. Anyway, guys, so that's the end of today's video. I hope you enjoyed the video. And don't forget, I do have a Patreon and memberships if you'd like to subscribe to one of those and join one of those and help me out. I'd greatly appreciate it. You don't have to, but yeah, it helps me a lot. And especially with buying this thing, I need the extra money. So yeah, that was disappointing, but hey, we got to see three generations of Mac Pro in one video, which I guess was fun. Anyway, guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video, and this has been a Hrutkay Mods video.